Hey guys, welcome to another Hostinger Academy video. My name is Kasturis, and today we will be learning how you can link CSS to an HTML document. So let's just jump right into it. Let's start by understanding the difference between hypertext markup language, also known as HTML, and cascading style sheets, also referred to as CSS. In short, HTML is responsible for the contents and the layout of your website, while CSS handles the style and presentation. You have three different methods of how you can link these two together. Internal CSS is written in the head section of the HTML document by adding the style tag. While a great way of styling a single page, it can be quite time-consuming if you're planning on using the same style on multiple pages. Here's an example. Let's begin by opening our HTML page and locating the head tag. This part of code changes the background color to blue. And this part of code changes the heading 1 color to red and padding to 60 pixels. Here's how your HTML file will look like. The advantage of using internal CSS is that you're able to use the class and ID selectors in the same file. The disadvantage, however, is that this type of CSS does increase your website's file size, which can ultimately lead to slower loading times. No worries though, there is an alternative to this. Using external CSS, we will link our HTML document to a CSS file which can be created by any text editor. This method is quite a bit more efficient, as editing a single CSS file can bring changes to your whole website at once, no matter how large it is. Let's first create our style.css file. You can give it any name you like, just make sure that it has the .css extension. Mine will look like this. Changing the body background color to yellow and changing the heading 1 color to blue and margin right to 30 pixels. Now let's head over to our HTML file. For better understanding, here's a breakdown of the attributes contained within the link tag. Rel defines the relationship between the link documents and the current one. Use the rel attribute only when the href attribute is present. Type determines the content of the linked file or document between the style opening and style closing tags. It has a text or CSS as default value. Href specifies the location of the CSS file you want to link to the HTML. If both HTML and CSS files are in the same folder, enter only the file name. Otherwise, include a folder name in which you stored the CSS file. Media describes the type of media the CSS styles are optimized for. In this example, we put screen as the attribute value to imply its use for computer screens. To apply the CSS rules to printed pages, set the value to print. Don't forget to change the style.css with the name of your .css file. The main advantages of this method are: number one, a cleaner HTML file, as all of your CSS will be located in a separate document, and number two, as mentioned before, you can use the same CSS document for multiple pages. The disadvantages, however, are improper page loading until the CSS file has been loaded completely, as well as longer page download times if there are multiple CSS files linked. Using inline CSS is only recommended when you're trying to make changes to a specific HTML element. Let's take a look at an example. Here we added an inline CSS to the P and H1 tags. What's advantageous about using inline CSS is that you can quickly add new rules to your HTML page, which is super handy if you'd like to preview some quick fixes to your website. However, if you're planning on doing this for every one of your HTML documents, it will be quite time consuming. Not to mention that the page file size will be increased. Adding CSS rules to your HTML page can be quite time consuming. I really hope that the methods we covered in this video will help you do that in the most efficient way. If you found this video helpful, leave a like. And of course, if there's any other topic you would like me to cover, leave them in the comments down below. Don't forget to use the promo code HA10 on your next Hostinger purchase, and until then, best of luck in your internet journey.